Coach Price, why did you decide to coach the Reggae Girls for free?
Well, it's just a commitment to the development of the sport, especially on the women's side, because we know that the women's team wasn't getting the sort of attention that was necessary. And on the behest of Sidella Marley, she actually asked us to come together with a team, and the coaching staff came together, and you know, we have been really working together. And the rest is history, you know. We have now qualified for the World Cup after a very long and hard battle, and you know, it's because of the teamwork that we made a dream work.
How much of the Reggae Girls' success is owed to the Alakan Foundation and the Bob Marley Foundation?
I owe a lot of success to them, because without them, we wouldn't be able to have the sort of camps and the support that we needed to go through the last 9 months. And they have been really supportive. Both the Alakan Foundation and the Bob Marley Foundation have been very supportive, along with the Jamaica Football Federation, to get us where we are. What we need now that we have qualified for France is for more corporate entities to come on and support and do the type of work that these two entities have been doing.
Yourself and head coach Hugh Menzies seemingly bounce off each other. What's it like working with him?
It's great, you know, it's a team, you know, the entire coaching staff is a team, and you know, we work together, we talk a lot, you know, we bounce ideas off each other, and we're always in sync, we're unified. Whenever we make decisions, we make it together. You know, a lot of people question why we made a substitution in extra time to put on the goalkeeper, Nicole McClure. It's something that we talked about prior to the game, and when the opportunity presented itself, we just made the decision, and it worked out for us.
What's it like working with this special group of girls?
It's a family affair, you know. Everybody works together in unity. We fight, of course, like everybody else, but guess what? At the end of the day, we are unified for one goal, and to do well for our country. We have some patriotic girls that love their country, willing to work hard. They made a lot of sacrifices, and it's really good that we have qualified for 2019, and we want to do more. We have got some success, but we're still thirsty for more success, and we'll continue to work together so that we can do that.
What can the world expect from the Reggae Girls?
We're going there to entertain, and one of the things I've told people, we're not just going there to participate, we're going there to be competitive, and that's what we want to prepare for. We want to prepare for France 2019, where we're going to go as far as we can go. So, you know, we're just looking forward to the draw come December 8th, and whoever we get in our group, we're ready for them.